So I'm talking about winter blooming plants. So this is kind of specific. So it's really cool, interesting things that for some reason, for I don't know why, horticulturally they choose to bloom in the winter. I don't know if it's based on insects or what, but really interesting things that only bloom during the winter when pretty much everything else is gone. This is the first one, which isn't technically a flower, but does anybody know what this is? Yeah, ornamental cabbage. Obviously spectacular, beautiful, almost better than a flower. Kind of like a giant flower, especially with like frost all over it. I love it. Anybody know these?
Pansy. Gotta be a pansy.
More specific.
Yellow. Purple.
Eastern.
These are actually violas. They're more related to the native one, or the, they're kind of smaller flowers. They have more of a fragrance. You get an interesting color range. This one's referring to the bottom. Anybody know what's on the bottom, the red things? Snapdragons, yes. Does anybody know why they're called snapdragons?
It's a cool name.
If you squeeze the back of the flower, it actually will like flap its mouth. They're really cool. And they also bloom kind of all year. Already said it. Pansy, yeah, this is a pansy. So it has a flower size 2 to 3 times larger than a viola. So there's pansies have large flowers, violas have small flowers. This one's actually called Frizzy Sizzle, which is really cool. Really beautiful flowers. They've come out with some crazy ones recently. Anybody know these? They're kind of the king, queen of winter. Anybody? Any landscape architects out there know these? Hellebores. There's tons of hellebores, and they've been coming out with all kinds of series. These are kind of hellebore orientalis, mixed hybrids. And this is a really amazing series they've come out with from out in Seattle. These are the Winter Jewel series, and they have great names like Onyx Odyssey and Sparkling Diamond and Jade Tiger, and they're spectacular. And they literally bloom in the middle of winter. This is a more specific hellebore species. Anybody know this? Any plant nerds out there? Anyone else? No. This is Helleborus foetidus. It's also known as bear hellebore or stinking hellebore. It doesn't smell bad, but it's kind of different. We gotta know this. Oh, come on, honeysuckle, no. No honeysuckle in this. No. Anyone? Mahonia. So it blooms kind of through in the dead of winter as well with these spectacular sprays of yellow flowers, and then in the summer in the spring it gets those crazy berries. Anyone know this one? Kind of blooming right now.
Carnations.
I heard it over here. Camellia, yes, good. Beautiful shrubs. They've just started coming out with ones that are more cold tolerant for our area. More prevalent in Alabama, Georgia. Camellia sasanqua is the one that's the best in our area. Anyone know this? No, winter blooming. Winter blooming. Cold. Piri's japonica is the name of this guy. And this one's called, Mountain Fire. Yeah. I'll be surprised if y'all know this. No. Edgeworthia. It's kind of borderline here, but it will grow here. It blooms in like January, February. It's crazy, and it's the most fragrant thing ever. You can smell it from like 50 feet away, and it's really cool. It has these tips on it. Anyone know this? This is a little more common.
Jasmine.
Yes, jasmine. It is not forsythia. The difference between jasmine and forsythia is jasmine has green stems. Forsythia's got more of a brown stem. Jasmine doesn't get as huge as forsythia for the most part, too. Jasmine's also a little more fragrant. Forsythia's not really fragrant. Anyone know this? Blooms in the winter. In, like, January. No? Anyone relatively know?
Bueller?
No. This is actually called Prunus mume. It's a flowering apricot. It's related to cherries and all that, but that one specifically blooms super early, one of the first trees to bloom. Anyone know this? No. No? Relative to? It's actually a dogwood. Blooms super early. It's Cornus moss. blooms this striking yellow. Again, that previous one and that one will bloom kind of together, and it's just, they're really bright. This is one of my other favorites, too. I don't expect y'all to know this. Chianthus, winter sweet. It's, again, you can smell it from like 100 yards away. You just know, the wind blows, and you're like, that Chianthus is blooming at Cheekwood. I have to find it. I know it's there somewhere. Anyone know this?
Magnolia something.
Yeah, magnolia something. Anyone know more specific magnolia something? I heard it over here. No, you're reading. The common name is star magnolia. A lot of times it blooms really early and gets burned because the flowers can't take frost. This is a really cool one. Coralopsis. It blooms kind of more late winter, early spring, but has these awesome little like dangling earrings all over it, and they like blow in the wind. They're really cool. Coralopsis is that one. Anyone know this? Common name? Witch hazel, maybe? Yes? No? Yeah. Never heard of it? Hamamelis virginica is the native one. Hamamelis japonica is obviously the one from Japan. There's crosses, lots of crosses between the two to get these crazy colors. And then we have our spring blooming bulbs, winter bulbs. Some of these bloom literally in January, February. We've got snowdrops. That bottom left one is winter aconite. If you're a plant nerd, you know what it is, which none of y'all do. Little dwarf iris, reticulata, trillium, those little thingies there. Yay! I hope y'all learned something. Thank you for amusing me.
All right, we're going to take a beer break. Is Jesse here? Jesse Manish? There she is. I wanted to thank her. She worked on the poster that you may have seen. In her defense, this was probably 2 or 3 months ago, we antagonized her to do that, and we thought we would be having some cold weather by now. So the whole sled thing and 60-degree weather isn't exactly what we had in mind, but it's a beautiful poster, and we want to thank her, so thank her. We'll be back in just a few minutes. Go get some beer.